Hi, I'm Michael Burton with michaelburtonfilms.org, located in Salt Lake City, Utah. We're here talking about using Microsoft Windows. Now I want to talk to you about how to manage different user accounts on your computer. Let me start out by saying that Windows XP is a registered trademark of Microsoft, and I am in no way affiliated with Microsoft. To manage different user accounts on your computer is very simple. We're going to go down to the Start menu, just the same as if we were to create a user account, by going to our Control Panel. Click User Accounts. This is our User Accounts menu. Now you can see at the bottom here that we have four separate user accounts. We have a HP Administrator account, which is my personal and business account that holds all my files for business. Then over here to the left, we have Windows Video account, which is the one that we are currently on, which you can view by going down here to the Start menu and clicking on the Start menu, and brings it up here at the top where you can see that that is the account that we're under. We also have created this new account for vid, new account for this video, that we're going to go ahead and show you how to maintain. Up here, they give you a few different options to either change an account, create a new one, or change the way the users log on or off. We're actually going to go ahead and click on the account down here. We're going to choose the new account for vid. It's going to give us a bunch of different options here as well on how to manage this user account. We can change the name, we can create a password, we can change the picture if you don't like the skateboarder, we can change the account type from, you know, HP administrator who has access to every file, or we can change it to limited, where someone would have limited access to all the files, or we can delete the account. Let's start with changing the name. Let's click on change the name. So instead of new account for vid, we want to make it the awesome user, okay? So now we're going to go down here to the where it says change name and click on that. Now our name has been changed. As you can see here on the right hand side, we are now the awesome user. You can see that our account type is still set to computer administrator, so let's go ahead and change that. So we go over here to the left under change the account type. It's going to ask us for computer administrator or limited. Let's choose limited, and then we'll scroll down here and choose change account type. Now, as you can see over here to the right, our account type has changed to limited account. Now let's go ahead and change out the picture because I don't like that skateboarder too much. Let's click on change the picture. Now, as you can see, they have a bunch of different options here for images. You can also download your own images off the internet or choose your own icons. Go ahead and choose, let's see, how about this dirt bike? That looks pretty cool. Choose the dirt bike. Again, you can browse for more pictures if you want to take a picture from your own personal collection or something that you've downloaded off the internet. But we're going to choose the motorcycle. Then we're going to come down here to the bottom right and click change picture. Now, as you can see, it hasn't made the change yet. But what you do is you close out of this and then you reopen your user accounts. And as you reopen your user accounts, you can see that our account has been changed from to awesome user with a limited account status and the motorcycle image. Now, let's click on this again. You can also see that we can create a password. If you were to click create a password, it would ask you here to type a new password, which right now we don't have one, so any password would do. Then we confirm by retyping that password, and then we want to give a word or phrase to use as a password hint in case we ever forget our password, maybe a mother's maiden name or a last pet or your best friend, something like that. Then you would come down here to the bottom right and create a password. I'm not going to create a password at this time because even if I want to show you how to log in, the recording program recording the screen won't allow us to do so. That's how you create a password. We're going to go ahead and cancel out of that. So that's how you manage your user accounts. And then, of course, the last thing is to delete the account, which we'll go ahead and do. It says, do you want to keep awesome users files? We're going to go ahead and delete the files because we don't want this account on our computer. And we're going to delete the account. And there you go.